Hi, this is Kurt with Traverse Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about how to mill steel, what tools to use, some things to avoid, and just tips in general. Steel is available in many different grades for a variety of applications. Just like with any kind of machining, good heat and chip control is essential to successful milling. Let's get started on the different types of materials that end mills are made from. So the first one we'll talk about is high-speed steel. That's going to be the least expensive, so it's the most economical if you're not going to be machining much. But if you're doing a lot of milling, you might want to jump up to a cobalt, which is a little bit more expensive, but it also lasts a little bit longer. Carbide end mills are a whole different animal than high-speed steel or cobalt. They're a little bit more expensive, but they'll last so much longer that if you're doing a lot of machining, they'll actually be a better value. It's a very hard material, so it keeps a sharp edge a lot longer, but because of the fact that it's so hard, it's also fragile, so you have to treat them carefully. I would never put carbide end mills just thrown in a drawer somewhere that you open and close. They can chip very easily, so be careful with them. When it comes to milling steel, you want your end mills to have at least 4 flutes. The more flutes you have on the end mill, the smoother the workpiece finish is going to be, and the longer the end mill is going to last. But a minimum of 4 is a good rule of thumb. If you're having a problem with your end mill chattering, you might want to look into a variable helix end mill. If you're machining a pocket in a workpiece and you're plunging the end mill in or even ramping it down at an angle, you have to use a center cutting end mill. Otherwise, it's going nowhere. Remember before I mentioned that carbide end mills are fragile? The corner tends to break off on those. That seems to be the first thing to chip. The solution for that is to use an end mill that has a corner radius on it. It's a lot tougher and it'll last a lot longer. If you have a lot of material that you need to remove in a hurry, you might want to consider a roughing end mill. You can really push the feeds and speeds on those things. It's called a roughing end mill for a reason. It's going to leave a rough finish behind on the workpiece, so you will need to follow it up with a finishing end mill to get that smooth finish that you need. An inexpensive way to get more life out of your end mills is with a coating. Some are better than others, but any of them are better than nothing. Some of the advantages of having a coating on your end mill is that it'll make the end mill last longer, it'll keep it sharper longer, which in turn makes it cut cooler, and it's like having a baked-on lubricant that could reduce or eliminate the need for cutting oil or coolant. If you still do need to lubricate your end mills, the best way to do that is with a flood coolant system. If you don't have the capability to do that though, a good thick and sticky cutting oil will do the job. My personal favorite is this extra thick cutting oil. It's so sticky that it stays on the tool longer. The hard job of a cutting oil is staying on the tool. It gets wiped off so easily, and I found that this lasts the longest of anything I've used. When it comes to milling steel, here's my list of priorities. My first priority would be the cutting parameters, so in other words, the depth and width of cut, the RPM and the feed rate, or what is commonly called feed and speed. My next priority would be the geometry of the end mill. So do I use a roughing or finishing end mill? How many flutes do I want? Do I want a variable helix? Etc. And the last priorities would be the end mill coating and the coolant or cutting oil I use, and if I want to use them. If you really want to be proficient at machining steel, maybe do some experimenting. Find a piece of scrap metal that you can just waste and make some chips on it. Do you still have questions? You need advice or recommendations on products? Feel free to reach out to our tech support team.